Candyland. I'll show y'all how to do the lighters. When I first started doing the lighters, this is what it came out looking like. Her pitch, you notice the clarity of the picture is not that good. It's a little bit dull because I used a regular Canon printer, so that's why it's dull. After a while, I end up getting a 7720 printer. See how the clarity of my pictures are a little bit better than these ones. This one I messed up a little bit. It got stuck on something. See, hers this way. This is this way. Might want to be careful about which pictures you pick. I mean, I picked this one. You notice it overlaps a little bit, but it actually shows a good other picture where with the strawberry. See how this one has her face a little bit, but you see how I had to cover it. Face ends there, but that's the other part of her hair. These ones, I like this one. It's a Unity one, so it goes all the way around. Doesn't really mess it up, the thing. But these ones, you can see how the hair overlaps. So just be very mindful of what pictures you pick. But, you know, I was experimenting, so I was just going to try a new little thing. Same thing with these. And like this one, too. See how it goes over there? I like the saying that it had on there, loving those skin I'm in. So, and then these ones, these are just a couple I've done. I usually went to the dollar store. You can get these at the dollar store, two pack, two of them for a dollar. Or you can get the single ones. These are also a dollar too. You can go ahead and grab these. I use some gloves because it gets kind of a little bit messy when you're doing a Mod Podge. I got, just wear these just so, and I got to hold that, and that Mod Podge can be kind of sticky and stuff and get all over the place. I actually already pre-printed this one out on my Epson 770. I got my Mod Podge right here. And I got the gloss lustre on that one. So I'm just going to cut the picture out. You can use one of those cutters like this. But I decided just to go ahead and use my scissors. It's a little bit faster using my scissors, because I can judge a little bit more if I need to cut any more. This time I'm trying the Kobe print, the Kobe picture, along with the Kansas City Chiefs. I haven't did that many as far as the NFL teams. I did do them in back scratchers, so that's the only ones I've done the NFL teams in, is the back scratchers. I'm almost done cutting these out. You don't want these too big, but you also don't want them too small, but you want them just enough so that you can wrap around the cigarette lighter. So I'm gonna cut some more off of here. I'm gonna take a little bit more on this side. You don't want to cut these too skinny because they won't wrap around the actual lighter. All right, where's my... And you can find these at the dollar store right up there near the register. So if you ever go to the dollar store, your regular Dollar Tree, just go up there near the registers and they should have them hanging up from there. They have some 3-pack ones, but those are, I don't know whether they're like off-brand ones, so I'm not gonna experiment too much with messing with those crazy ones like that. I forgot to cut this one this way. You see this one, when you put them up there, see how it covers? We needed to cover on that bottom part, so we don't have to cut that much off the bottom. Sometimes they may be a little bit longer, you can just cut it off the bottom, but these ones, I got it just so that I don't have to cut off the bottom. So I decided to use the Kobe one. You can pull these off, these little stickers, but I notice when you put them off, they get kind of sticky, and it's hard when you're trying to put the picture on there, and it's hard to stay in place. So what I do is I open up the Mod Podge. I have a whole bunch of these ones. So I just go ahead and put these on here first. Just put the Mod Podge on here first like this. I just want to get enough on it. You don't have to cake it all on there because you're going to put the other ones on there. You just need enough to, so when you put that piece of paper on there, it just want to stick. And that's why I wear the gloves. See how nasty and messy it gets. So now here comes the hardest part. Just trying to put this on here just right. So I got that right there. So once I get the first part on there like that, then I put some more on there just so I can seal on that other side. That's another reason why you should wear gloves, because just in case you need to smooth it out with your hands, this makes it a little bit easier. So now I'm going to pull the other part right over top of it. So see how it seals just like that. So now I'm just going to put the rest of the Mod Podge on there. So that's where you can cake it up down there. You can get gloves from the local, what you call it, like Walgreens, Rite Aid, any one of them places. You can get any kind of gloves. Or even, I guess, I think it might sell them at the hardware store. I'm not really sure. So after I get done that, I just sit them up on something. Actually, I have a little makeshift Advil bottle. I just usually leave them like that, just so they can dry some. Because I don't want it to touch any other paper, and I don't want to necessarily touch things, but I want it to dry right away. So, I'm going to do the next one. Let me see. Yeah, I'll do this one. I should have done this in the autism one. I want to do this one, the autism one, so I'm going to cut that one out real fast. That's why I should always have the pictures cut out beforehand. But practice makes perfect. I think I made this one too short, to tell you the truth. Yep, I just did it just right. The reason why I place it down so I can get it down, because you want to make sure you don't have no bubbles. You want to make sure you get it sealed on there right, the right way. Just want to put them a little bit kind of crooked, but practice makes perfect. I can always do another one if somebody wants one. I'll probably use this one more as a display. I just do other ones because I let people know that it's not pretty like the black images. I'm doing all different color kind of images. Now I'm gonna try one with the scriptos. Now with the scripto one, I'm gonna use this Kansas City Chiefs. Love. just like the 770 printer because the clarity of the pictures are so much better on the 770. Now, I still do use my Canon one because sometimes when I'm making like stickers, they go on shipping labels. And if I use the glossy kind, I can't use my 770 printer for the simple fact that it bleeds too much on that kind of paper. So I have to watch out what kind of papers I use. And I actually have four printers. Okay, let's see if we get this good. See, now I gotta redo this one over, cause see? It's not covering all the way. So these ones, I realize, are gonna have to be wider. Let me see if this one. Okay, I can use this one. So I'm gonna pull this one off because it's not stuck all the way. But I noticed with these ones, this one had to be a little bit longer, so I can't cut that much off the picture. For the simple fact, because this is much thicker, I mean, it's much wider than the other one. Well, I said practice makes perfect. We're gonna run into there. And after I get done, I'll wipe these down with alcohol for all the other excessive Mod Podge. I use the surface to put it down there because it just makes it easier for me to wrap these around. See how it came better with the, I know it probably would have better with a purple color, but I'm just going to do this with this color. Since I did it short. So I'm going to fold in a little bit. So you see how it's longer than the actual lighter. And you don't want to get all that stuff in the bottom of here because I noticed with this one, it's a this one actually is a refillable one. You can actually, as long as you have butane, you can actually refill this. Oops, I got my thing down there too much. Sometimes if you have excessive paper at the bottom, you can cut it. You can cut it. It all depends on you. So I'm gonna let these sit up here and dry. That was in there. We got it taken care of. And that concludes that part. Then after they dry, if you need to go a couple more coats, you can put more cup holders on there. But when they dry, they look like this. This is what it looks like when it dries. So then the picture really pops. And if you need notice you need to go over with a second coating, you can go over with a second coating. So I hope this video was helpful to whoever wants to do the cigarette lighters. I actually watched a couple of videos to find out how to do it. And then I was like, oh, this is real easy. It's just trying to pick the right picture and trying to, when you, I have the Epson 7720 app, so that way I'm actually able to shrink my picture up. So when I actually do it, I can shrink it up to make it that size. I don't have to change the printer. So I, you notice I have a big 8x11 piece of sheet of paper, but I shrink it up to about like a little bit above a 5x7, just so I can go ahead and print it out, and those are easy to put on there. So you see how this one is starting to dry a little bit now. See, the picture still looks vibrant and the colors are coming clear, so it'll come out looking good in a little bit. I don't think I need to hit it over again, but that's how the pictures are gonna come out. The Kobe one is coming out too. So it's got him right here on this side. His daughter's looking that way. So let them sit there and dry. All right, thank you. Have a nice night. And I hope that video was helpful. I haven't did a YouTube channel yet. I think I actually got a YouTube channel. I don't know what the thing of it is, but when I do find one, I'll put it in the comment section. But these are the first of many videos. I'm actually starting to work on these next Starbucks cups, and actually putting the images on here. So these are my next things to work on, and getting these sealed so that way when they hand wash them, the stickers don't come off. All right, talk to you later. Bye-bye.